I have discovered some of the compounds, I have given it to my own name. If someone has discovered any organic compound or synthesized in the laboratory, he has given his own
exactly
name.
What the word root? Word root exactly tells us what is the number of carbon atom present in the hydrocarbons or the functional or the.
We will switch to the word root. For word root, we have to find out how many number of carbon atoms are present over here. So see, yes, this will be your task. How can you write the nomenclature of this one? Hello students, welcome to e-learning with Ankit. I hope your studies for your upcoming examinations going well and good. Number of times I have seen that you are facing a problem regarding the IUPAC nomenclature of hydrocarbons, which is relevant to your chapter carbonates compound of class 10th chemistry. So today in this video we will cover about the exactly how we are going to write the IUPAC nomenclature of hydrocarbons. Just because I have written over here IUPAC nomenclature, but still we will discuss some of the common nomenclatures of the more than three or four different compounds only, because those common nomenclatures are also important regarding your questions perspective. One more important thing is that the complete notes of this chapter, that is carbonates compound, is given in the description. Link is there, you can go and check it out. It's my own handwritten PDF notes, so just go and avail that notes, have that notes, and you can read with that notes also. It's literally the notes is relevant up to your board examinations. It's quite significant, we can say, they're related to your board examinations. So just let's see how we are going to write the IUPAC nomenclature. While I will be teaching you this nomenclature, I will keep the sort of the things which is related only up, means which is up to your NCERT level, not going just beyond the NCERT level. Main sirf utna hi basics rakhunga. So just let's start the IUPAC nomenclature. Before starting IUPAC nomenclature, there is a one word written, that is just IUPAC. Just before that, let me tell you exactly what this word means. It means International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry. Now question arises, why there is a importance of writing the nomenclature, iski zarurat kyun padi? So listen, exactly thing is that earlier it was thought that ki jitne bhi organic compounds hai, whatever the organic compounds that we have, was made by nature. ठीक है, उसमें कुछ एक हिडन फोर्स लगते हैं. देर आर सम हिडन फोर्स कॉल्ड एज अ वाइटल फोर्स थियरी विच इज रिक्वायर्ड टू मेक दिस ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स. बट लेटर ऑन विद सम एक्सपेरिमेंट्स, दैट इज नॉट गोइंग टू डिस्कस ओवर हियर, वीडियो लेंदी हो जाएगा. सो कुछ सर्टेन एक्सपेरिमेंट्स के दौरान इन द लैबोरेटरी इट वॉज फाउंड दैट देयर इज नो ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स कैन बी सिंथेसाइज, कैन बी ऑब्टेन इन द लैबोरेटरी. तो वहां से एक मिथ दूर हुआ. सो लेट्स से इफ आई हैव डिस्कवर सम ऑफ द कंपाउंड्स, आई हैव गिवन इट टू माई ओन नेम. इफ समवन हैज डिस्कवर्ड एनी ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड और सिंथेसाइज इन द लैबोरेटरी, he has given his own name. So literally it was going to be very problematic to learn exactly different names of the different organic compounds that was keeps on synthesized by different scientists in the laboratory. So that's why IUPAC, that is International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry, has given a rule, a set of norms, set of rules through which we can write the nomenclature of any of the organic compounds, including functional groups also. So without any further delay, let's start that how can we write the nomenclature. So as I said that to write the nomenclature, IUPAC has given some sort of rules. So I'm going to write them some sort of rules. Have a pen paper with you. You all can also write. First of all, we'll write prefix, and then after word root, and then after suffix word will be written. Listen, in some of the books you will find out that primary prefix will also be there, secondary suffix will also be there, primary suffix will also be there. As in the starting of video I told you that I'm not going to take you through the beyond the class 10th level, main uske beyond nahi ja raha hu, so that's why I'm not discussing. Even that concept would not be required also here. So just I'm keeping the concept relevant only up to class 10th. Okay, prefix, word root, and then suffix. One by one ek karke hum cheezon ko samjhenge. First of all, we will try to learn what the prefix, then after word root, and then after suffix, then only we will get to know that how can we write the nomenclature. See, the prefix is written, I remember Hindi mein aapne ye padha hoga shayad, upsarga and pratyay. So like in prefix, the word that is written before the nomenclature, means starting of the nomenclature, jab hum koi compound likh rahe hain, so uske starting mein jo likhenge, the word that will be written at the starting of the nomenclature will be called as a prefix. Talking about the word root, that I'll later on I'll let you know, and then after suffix. Suffix word will be written at the end of the nomenclature. और क्या लिखना है वहाँ पे, that I will be telling you later on. ठीक, तो देखो prefix हमने क्या बताया यहाँ पे, the prefix will be written at the starting of the nomenclature. It will be written at the starting of the nomenclature.
word root and then after suffix. Suffix word will be written as the end of the nomenclature. Sorry, at the end of nomenclature. Okay. Now, exactly what the word root? Word root exactly tells us what is the number of carbon atom present in the hydrocarbons or the functional or the compound which is given that. It is the number of number of carbon atoms present over here. Number of carbon atom present over here. So different groups, different functional groups have different their prefixes, and similarly unke prefix suffix bhi alag hote hain, prefix suffix alag hote hain. But in case of word root will also be always be same over here. Like what? If in case the organic compounds contain one number of carbon atom, it contains two carbon atoms, it contains three carbon atom, it contains four carbon atom, comes subsequently 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 different carbon atoms. For that, how we are going to write the how we are going to write its word root? For in case agar carbon compound mein aapke ek carbon atom present hai, there you will write the word meth word. In case two carbon atoms are present, you will write the word eth word. In case three carbon atoms, prop word will be written. In case four carbon atom, remember but word is not a but. Take English mein jo but word hai, it's not like that. You have to pronunciate as a but word. In case five carbon atom are present here, the pent word will be written. In case six carbon atoms are there, you will write the hex word. And seven carbon atoms, so there you will write the hept word. Remember, hept word, not sept word. In inorganic chemistry, we are talking about the organic chemistry. In inorganic chemistry, we write only sept, sept word for seven. But in case of organic chemistry, hept word likhenge yahan pe. This must be remembered by you. For 8 carbon atom, oct word will be written, and for 9 carbon atom, non word will be written. So these are the hydrocarbons that we are going to utilize while writing the nomenclature of hydrocarbons. Now talking about the prefix and suffix. So prefix suffix directly is tarike se nahi batate hain. Let me take you through the some of the examples. There we will get to know that how we are going to utilize prefix and suffix. So before that, I am going to write some sort of hydrocarbons, and of course I am very well sure that you must be having an idea what is hydrocarbons and types of even hydrocarbon like alkane, alkene and alkyne. To kuch wahi examples main yahan pe likhta hu. Here I am writing, let us suppose CH4, C2S6. These are the different hydrocarbons, and of course these hydrocarbons are the alkanes, alkenes and alkynes might be. So some sort of hydrocarbons I am writing over like C3 S6 C4 H8 C3 H4 C2 H2. So before starting nomenclature, thoda sa ek baar aapko bata deta hu ki how can we classify whether it's the alkane, alkene or alkyne. So dekho, jo alkene hota hai, in case of alkane, we have the general formula CnH2n+2. It is a formula of alkane, yo. And in case if it is an alkene, so this formula will be CnH2n. In case if it is an alkyne, its formula will be CnH2n-2. It is your alkene and it's an alkyne. अब देखो, अगर जब आपको नहीं पता है, इफ यू डोंट नो व्हाट्स एल्केन, एल्कीन एंड एल्काइन, फॉर दिस टाइम बीइंग आई कैन से इन एल्केन देयर विल बी द कार्बन कार्बन सिंगल बॉन्डिंग, इन एल्कीन देयर विल बी कार्बन कार्बन डबल बॉन्डिंग, एंड इन एल्काइन देयर विल बी कार्बन कार्बन ट्रिपल बॉन्डिंग. मींस देयर विल बी द ट्रिपल बॉन्डिंग बिटवीन टू कार्बन एटम्स, देयर विल बी डबल बॉन्डिंग इन केस बिटवीन टू कार्बन एटम्स, और सिंगल बॉन्डिंग होगा आपका एल्केन के केस में. Now try to find out. Here you will can compare this CN. CN is common in every whether it's alkane, alkene or alkyne. So dekho, sab mein se aap common karo. In case here I am talking about C2. So their value of N is equals to 2. Value of N is equals to 2, or we may is formula ko apply karne ja raha. So here we have the hydrogen 2N+2. So in that case you will find out 2N. Value of N is equals to 2 over here because we have taken C2 as a CN. So on comparing C2 with the CN, we found that N is equals to 2. So 2 into 2 plus 2, we will get 4 plus 2 is equals to 6. Or 6 yahan pe hamare paas hai bhi. So it does mean it's your alkane, because yahi formula hame apply karne pe mila hai. This is how you can find out for each and every one whether it's an alkane, alkene or alkyne. Similarly, C3S6, here value of N is equals to 3, 3 to just 6, direct you can see there, 2 times of N. So here also 3 to just 6, 2 times of N you are getting. So it does mean this 2N is equals to 6 you are getting. So it does mean it's a alkene because we are applying this one formula. Talking about C3H4, here N is equals to 3, on substituting this formula, that is 2N minus 2. 2 into 3 minus 2, you will get 2, 3 is 6. 6 minus 2 is equals to 4. Yes, the value of hydrogen over here means the number of hydrogen atom here is 4. So, yahan pe mera is formula apply karne pe hai, that is alkyne. So, in this case, C3H4, at least one triple bonding will be present between two subsequent carbon atoms. Adjacent carbon atoms also we can say. So, this is how you are going to find out whether the given hydrocarbon is alkane, alkene or alkyne. And one more important thing is that in case if it is an alkane, dhyan rakhiyega, in case if it is an alkane, the suffix ane word will be written. Remember, I am saying suffix word. But in case if there is an alkene, the suffix ene word will be written. And in case if alkyne is present, so the suffix ine word will be written. Again, I am saying, fir se bol de raha, suffix I am talking about. Suffix ane, ene and ine will be written at the end of the nomenclature. Because starting I told you, suffix kahan likhte hain, hum log end mein likhte hain. Now let me tell you about the prefixes, how we will write the prefix. Okay, abhi word root hume clear ho gaya. We all know about the suffix, how we are going to utilize the suffix. And now it's turn to utilize the prefix as well. So for the prefix, let me tell you about functional group. What exactly the functional group? Tabhi ye cheez main aapko samjha paunga. So a lot of the functional groups we have, I am just going to draw a table over here. You can also draw the table, but still this table is given in NCERT textbook. So some sort of functional group is here. Here am I writing? Type of functional group. Type of functional groups and its suffix and then prefix. In some of the books you will find out ki prefix pehle likha hai, abhi maine yahan pe likh diya, to aisa such kuch se koi we don't have any problem for that. Type of functional groups over here. So very first functional group jo hum keh sakte hain, that is halogens. Halogens. Ab kya hai ye halogens? What are those halogens? Like the atoms that we say na, the fluorine, chlorine, bromine and iodine, these are the halogens. Means fluorine, chlorine, bromine and iodine. The way I have written here, fluorine, chlorine, bromine and iodine, exactly, absolutely it's wrong. इस तरीके से आपको नहीं लिखना है, बिकॉज इट्स रिटन फंक्शनल ग्रुप ओवर हियर. सो जब भी हम किसी ग्रुप की बात करते हैं, पीछे एक बॉन्डिंग इस तरीके से जरूर दिखाते हैं. रिमेंबर, इट्स नॉट अ डैश, इट्स नॉट अ सिंबल ऑफ सब्ट्रैक्शन, ये आपका एक बॉन्डिंग को रिप्रेजेंट करता है बिकॉज इट्स अ ग्रुप. नाउ व्हाट द सफिक्स वी विल यूज ओवर हियर. तो इसके सफिक्स कुछ नहीं होता, प्रेफिक्स ओनली वी विल यूज हियर. लाइक फॉर फ्लोरीन, इन केस इफ देयर इज अ फ्लोरीन एटम इज अटैच्ड टू द हाइड्रोकार्बन्स लाइक एज सच, ये आपके पास अगर कंपाउंड दे, इन केस फ्लोरीन इज अटैच्ड, सो यू विल यूज द वर्ड फ्लोरो. In case of fluorine, chloro word. In case of bromine, bromo word will be written. And in case of iodine, iodo word will be written. ठीक है, कुछ इस तरीके से आप यहाँ पे वर्ड्स का यूज कर रहे होंगे. नाउ टॉकिंग अबाउट नेक्स्ट फंक्शनल ग्रुप, देखो अगली फंक्शनल ग्रुप हम लोग के पास क्या होगा. नेक्स्ट वन, नेक्स्ट फंक्शनल ग्रुप इज अल्कोहल्स. अल्कोहल्स, फॉर अल्कोहल्स द सिंबल इज OH. ये OH होता है हम लोग का, ठीक है. रिमेंबर, इसके लिए जो सफिक्स यूज होगा, द सफिक्स दैट वी विल यूज विल बी ऑल, OL. द स्टूडेंट्स, दोज हु आर राइटिंग इन कर्सिव राइटिंग, उनका ओ और एल दोनों एक साथ होगा. सो ट्राई टू रिमेंबर रिमेंबर दिस थिंग वाइल राइटिंग द IUPAC नॉमेनक्लेचर, मेक इट डिफरेंस. क्योंकि वन मोर नॉमेनक्लेचर वी विल हैव फॉर द एल्डिहाइड, तो वहां पे AL होता है, उस बात का ध्यान रखना. OL. एंड फॉर द प्रेफिक्स, देखो इसका प्रेफिक्स होता तो है, बट अप टू योर क्लास 10th लेवल ऐसे क्वेश्चंस आपको नहीं पूछे जाएंगे. यू वोंट बी आस्क द क्वेश्चंस वेयर यू विल हैव टू यूज द प्रेफिक्स ऑफ दैट इज अल्कोहल्स. बट अगर आप जानना चाहोगे तो बता दूंगा, वी कैन यूज द प्रेफिक्स हाइड्रोक्सी वर्ड विल बी यूज एज अ प्रेफिक्स. सो इट्स हियर. देन आफ्टर एल्डिहाइड इज हियर. एल्डिहाइड, फॉर एल्डिहाइड द फॉर्मूला वी हैव इज द CHO. फॉर्मुला वी हैव द सी एच ओ. ठीक है, देखो सबके पीछे देखो मैं बॉन्डिंग लगा रहा हूँ. इट एन ईच एंड एवरी फंक्शनल ग्रुप आई एम प्लेसिंग दिस लाइक अ बॉन्डिंग. इट्स नॉट अ डैश, इट्स नॉट सिंबल. अगेन आई एम सेइंग दिस थिंग. सी एच ओ इज प्रेजेंट. फॉर सी एच ओ इट्स सफिक्स विल बी ए एल, अल वर्ड विल बी रिटेन. अगेन वी ऑल्सो हैव द प्रेफिक्स फॉर दिस वन ऑल्सो, बट हमें नहीं यूज करना है प्रेफिक्स हियर. लास्ट वन, सॉरी नॉट लास्ट, सेकेंड लास्ट वन, दैट इज कीटोन, के ई टी ओ एन ई, कीटोन. इट्स सिंबल इज सी डबल बॉन्ड ओ, कीटोन. It's your ketone. For the ketone, the suffix will be used here. It's a own word, O-N-E. Remember, it's not a one. You will have to pronunciate it as a own. Again, prefix kuch nahi hai iska. Sorry, it's a prefix is there. Keto and oxo word is a prefix here. But in your class 10th level, up to your class 10th level, hum iska use nahi karna. Aise questions aapko nahi puchhe jayenge. And last one, that is a carboxylic acid. Carboxylic acid. For the carboxylic acid, you might be familiar with this in your chapter acid base and salt, COOH. It's your carboxylic acid. For this, the suffix that we are going to use is oic acid, O-I-C, oic acid. So these are the suffix that we are going to utilize, that we are going to use while writing the IUPAC nomenclature of hydrocarbons. Only prefix will be retained only for the halogens. What are the halogens? Fluorine, chlorine, bromine and iodine. Sirf inke liye aapko use karna hai. Do important cheez dekho, mujhe yahan pe aapko batana tha ye, CHO and COH. In case CHO or COH, if it's not given as such, kuch is tarike se question mein nahi diya, to usko aap kaise find out karoge, ye cheez dekh lo. Yahan additional aap isko likh lena yahan pe. CHO, it means its structure will be as such, C double bond OH. This is way if it's written, कहीं आप देखो किसी compounds में, in case if there is a double bonding with this oxygen atom and hydrogen is attached to that the same carbon atom, make it clear, at the very instant the given compound is your aldehyde. Similarly, in case of carboxylic acid, if any carbon atom is given, if with that carbon atom double bonding oxygen is given and the very with the very same carbon atom its OH group is present, make it clear, at the very next the very same moment it's a carboxylic acid. Dekh sakte ho, you have COOH. Take a screenshot of this. We will discuss some of the examples through which we can write the nomenclatures. In case if it's a given compound, like it's a C2H6, if I'm writing C2H6, so remember C2H6 can also be written as a CH3. If this compound is given, how we are going to write the nomenclature? अब देखो, अभी जो table हमने बनाया था, with the help of the table, you can see none of the CHO group is present over here. Not aldehyde, aldehyde already said, not alcohol, as well as the carboxylic acid, कुछ भी नहीं present है यहाँ पे. Means in that case, we don't have to use the suffix all, we don't have to use the suffix oic acid, own, ketone के लिए, ठीक है, कुछ भी ऐसा हमें यहाँ पे नहीं use करना है. Only we have to now think about halogens. Halogens is also not present over here, like fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, nothing such is present over here. मतलब कोई prefix हमको नहीं use करना पे, no prefix will be used over here. Directly we will switch to the word root. For word root, we have to find out how many number of carbon atoms are present over here. So see, two carbon atoms are present, one and two. For two carbon atoms, the word root eth word will be written. So here I will write here eth word, and then after word root suffix will be written. In case I told you, since it's an alkane, single bonding yahan pe for alkane, abhi kuch der pehle humne yahan pe likha tha, in case of an alkane the suffix will be written over here, that is a single bonding, an word will be written. So eth plus an, and its nomenclature will be ethane. This is how you can write the simple nomenclature of hydrocarbons. Similarly, discussing few more examples, CH4 if it's given. वन कार्बन एटम इज ओनली हियर, ठीक है. अब फाइंड आउट करो आप वेदर इट्स एल्केन, एल्कीन और एल्काइन. कैसे फाइंड करोगे? हाउ आर गोइंग टू फाइंड आउट? द नंबर ऑफ कार्बन एटम इज वन. सो इफ द नंबर ऑफ कार्बन एटम इज वन, दैट इज एन इज इक्वल्स टू वन. एंड इन केस एल्केन के केस में हमें पता है हाइड्रोजन कितना होता था, 2n+2. सो ऑन सब्सटीट्यूटिंग द वैल्यू ऑफ एन इज इक्वल्स टू वन, यू विल फाइंड आउट हियर 2 × 1+2 इज इक्वल्स टू 2+2 इज इक्वल्स टू 4. सो यस, लिटरली द हाइड्रोजन इज 4 ओवर हियर, एंड वी आर ऑब्टेनिंग दिस 4 बाय अप्लाइंग द फॉर्मूला 2n+2, व्हिच वाज द फॉर्मूला ऑफ एन एल्केन. सो यस, इट्स एन एल्केन. और इसका नॉमिनेचर अब लिखते हैं. For here we can see the number of carbon atom is 1. For in case the number of carbon atom is 1, meth word will be written. And since it is an alkane, the suffix word will be written as a an word. So its nomenclature will be methane. This is how we write the nomenclature of CH4 as a methane. Next one, if it's written C3H7, like say. Similarly, CH3 can also be written as a C2H6. In case if it's a written C3, not C3H7, of course it's a C3H8. How we are going to write the nomenclature? Sometimes question might be asked as such also. Since it is not clearly visible whether it's a double bonding, triple bonding or single bonding, so here you have to find out ki alkane, alkene or alkyne based upon the formula that I have just recently erased here. In case the number of carbon atom, here it's the number of carbon atom is 3. So 3 to just 6, 6 plus 2, 8. So 2n plus 2 formula I am using over here. It does mean it's your alkane. In case it's alkane, suffix will be used over is ane word. And the number of carbon atom is 3. So since the number of carbon atom is 3, the prop word will be retained. So we'll write over here prop. And since it's alkane, so the suffix will be used here in, so its nomenclature will be propane. So direct is tarike se bhi aap nomenclature ko bata sakte ho. Let's discuss one more example, uske baad kuch aur additional cheeze batani hai. Like it's written is C4H10, it's given. Again 4 to 8, 8 plus 2, 10 means 2n plus 2 again we are using. So it does mean it's also an alkane, and for alkane the suffix will be used in word. And since the number of 4 carbon atoms, for 4 carbon atoms but word will be written. So its nomenclature will be but and single bonding ane. So butane it will be its nomenclature. This is how you can write the nomenclature of simple hydrocarbons, like starting from methane, ethane, propane and butane. This is how you can write the simple nomenclatures. Take ab yahan se thoda sa twist hai. And what is that? Since if I'm writing over here CH4, we all know that since the nomenclature is methane. If I'm writing over here C2H6, हमें सबको पता है इट्स ethane. C3H8, if I'm writing here it's a propane. देख लो आपने ये सब हम लिखा भी आपने. In case if I'm writing over here C4H10, so you will call it as a butane. Of course, it's a butane. So अभी देखो यहाँ पे different क्या करना है हम लोग को. What's the different we are going to write? If from this CH4, what I am doing is CH4 से एक hydrogen remove करते हैं. I'm removing one hydrogen from this CH4. One hydrogen from this CH4, and we knew that it's a nomenclature, it's a methane. Similarly, here also I am removing one hydrogen from this ethane compound, it's a nomenclature, it's ethane. In from each and every, har ek case se yahi kaam kar raha hu, one hydrogen is removing, it's a nomenclature, it's a propane. And the last one, again removing one hydrogen, it's a nomenclature, it's a butane. So do one thing, since we are removing one hydrogen, आप भी काम करो यहाँ से. Do one thing, इसकी word से an word हटा दो यहाँ सबसे, ठीक है? An word सबसे हटा दो, aryl word लगा दो यहाँ पे, ठीक है? Like what means, what I am saying that if it's a methane, an word हटा के aryl लगा दो, its nomenclature will be methyl, ठीक है? Means the compound will be what, like CH3 now. Remember, now it's the group. Now it's a group. Since it's a group, that's why देखो यहाँ पे मुझे एक bonding यहाँ पे मैं show कर रहा हूँ. Similarly in case of C2H6, removing one hydrogen atoms, it will be ethane में से an हटा के aryl word add करो, you will find out it's like a ethyl word, and its the formula will be C2H5. Similarly propane, an word हटाओ, aryl word when it will be placed, its nomenclature will be propyl word. ठीक है? Sometimes it will also called as a propyl is the correct pronunciation, and its formula will be C3H7. But in case it's a butane, again sir, removing this an word and with the word aryl, you will write it as a butyl, not a butyl, it's a butyl word, and the formula will be C4H9. So whenever, in case if any of the compound CH3 is given, C2H5 is given, remember branching ke case mein, agar branch mein kuch aisa present hai like CH3, C2H5, C3H7, C4H9, try to find out whether it's a methyl, ethyl, propyl or butyl. Means while you are writing the nomenclature, it must include these words, ethyl, methyl, propyl, propyl, butyl. Okay, that's why I'm telling you, just write it immediately. Iski jarurat padhegi aapko. Dekho kaise, just relating with these, means relating with these, I'm going to tell you some sort of the nomenclatures. Although because ye some nomenclatures hamare kafi easy the. See, CH3. CH2, CH3 and CH3. See how we are going to write the nomenclature. अब देखो यहाँ पे starting में, in starting we have some rules, ठीक है? वो rule मैंने starting में आपको नहीं बताया था. Here I am going to tell you that rule. What is that? First of all, we have to find out the longest possible chain. So since we said that the longest possible chain, क्योंकि देखो यहाँ पे ये rule बताने का कोई sense नहीं था. How would you have found that the longest possible chain? यहाँ पे कोई ऐसा तुक्की नहीं था बताने का. So that's why I have ignored. But here I am telling you, ठीक है? इस rule से पहले दो additional rule आपको add करना वहाँ पे. And what is that? You have to find out the longest possible chain. So since I am saying that the longest possible मल्टीपल चेन, इट डजेंट मीन दैट, इसका ये मतलब नहीं है कि द चेन मस्ट बी स्ट्रेट चेन ओनली, चेन मस्ट बी लॉन्गेस्ट ओनली. इट्स नॉट कि ऐसा नहीं है कि वो चेन हमारा एकदम स्ट्रेट ही होना चाहिए, बस लॉन्गेस्ट होना चाहिए, ब्रेक नहीं होना चाहिए. मीन्स ऐसा नहीं कि इस कार्बन के पास आप यहाँ जंप कर जाओगे, दिस विल बी कंटिन्यूअस एज सच, दिस माइट बी दिस वन ऑल्सो, लाइक दिस कार्बन एंड दिस कार्बन, मीन्स चेन मस्ट बी कंटिन्यूअस. सो आई एम जस्ट गोइंग टू एड दिस रूल, आप यहाँ पे लिख लो इसको, द चेन मस्ट बी द लॉन्गेस्ट पॉसिबल वन. The chain must be longest possible one, and third one you have to use. Sorry, second one you have to utilize that the LSR. What does it? This word LSR means? This LSR means lowest sum rule. In some of the books you might find out it's a locant sum rule. In some of the book you will find out it's a least sum rule or locant sum rule also. But concept सबका एक ही है. And what's that concept? The groups which is attached. What group? Functional group. Although मैंने functional group के बारे में इस video में नहीं बताया है. Complete एक one shot solution आपके पास है, description में मिल जाएगा, वो उसमें मैंने discuss किया हुआ है. सो जो ग्रुप्स प्रेजेंट है, व्हाटएवर द ग्रुप्स आर प्रेजेंट इन द हाइड्रोकार्बन्स, उसको लीस्ट पोजीशन मिलना चाहिए. कैसे लीस्ट पोजीशन मिलेगा, अभी क्वेश्चन हम लोग करते जाएंगे तो समझ में आएगा आपको. चलो तो सबसे पहला देखते हैं, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, व्हाट इज द लॉन्गेस्ट पॉसिबल चेन ओवर हियर. सो आई कैन फाइंड आउट द लॉन्गेस्ट पॉसिबल चेन इज 1, 2, 3 ओवर हियर. 1, 2, 3 किधर साइड से भी चलो आपको लॉन्गेस्ट पॉसिबल चेन यहाँ में मिल रहा है. इन ऑर्डर टू अवॉइड द मिस्टेक, एक काम करो, यहाँ पे नॉमेनक्लेचर करते समय मेक इट इन ए स्क्वायर बॉक्स, सॉरी रेक्टेंगल बॉक्स. इट्स नॉट अ रूल, जस्ट फॉर द योर सेक ऑफ सिंप्लिसिटी, इन ऑर्डर टू अवॉइड द मिस्टेक, सिर्फ हम इसलिए मैं ऐसा बता रहा हूँ. एंड देन आफ्टर LSR रूल मीन्स द ग्रुप्स विच इज प्रेजेंट मस्ट गेट द लीस्ट पोजिशन. अब ग्रुप्स कौन सा प्रेजेंट है ये देख लो, लाइक इन केस ऑफ ब्रांचिंग CH3 इज प्रेजेंट, एंड लिटरली जस्ट देर वेरी फ्यू मिनट्स बैक आई टोल्ड यू CH3 इज कॉल्ड एज अ मिथाइल वर्ड, इसको हम मिथाइल कहते हैं. एंड वॉट पोजिशन इज प्रेजेंट, किस पोजिशन पे स्टार्ट करो नंबरिंग, 1, 2, 3. If I'll start the numbering from this side also, 1, 2, 3, इधर से भी आपको 2 ही मिलेगा. Means from each and every side, whether starting from the left side or the right side, we are getting the CH3, that is methyl group attached on the second position. तो least sum rule यहाँ पे को हमारा violate नहीं कर रहा है, वो same दोनों तरफ से आ रहा, तो कोई दिक्कत हमें नहीं है. ठीक, CH3, all these, remember these are the groups which will be always used as a prefix. लिख लेना, these all the groups which will always be used as a प्रेफिक्स, इनको हम एज अ प्रेफिक्स ही यूज करेंगे, ऑलवेज वी विल यूज इट्स एज अ प्रेफिक्स. एंड वी नो दैट द प्रेफिक्स विल बी रिटन एट द स्टार्टिंग ऑफ द नॉमेनक्लेचर, देन व्हाट डू एंड देन आफ्टर सफिक्स. सो सी हाउ वी आर गोइंग टू राइट दिस नॉमेनक्लेचर. सो ऑन द सेकेंड पोजिशन वी हैव द मिथाइल ग्रुप, सो यू विल राइट ओवर हियर 2 मिथाइल, द फर्स्ट लेटर विल बी कैपिटल 2 methyl, and then after word root. For word root we have to find out the number of carbon atoms. So some of you can say that ki sir number of carbon atoms yahan pe 4 hai. But we have to find out the number of carbon atom in the straight chain only, sorry, in the longest possible chain, जो हमारा parent chain है. This parent chain is this one only, जिसमें 3 carbon atoms present है. So in case 3 carbon atoms is present, prop word will be written. So 2 methyl prop, and then after you can see that there is a single bonding between each and every carbon atom. So since the single bonding is present over here, so that means the suffix will be written over here, it's a N. So its a nomenclature will be 2 methyl propane. This is how you can write the nomenclature of hydrocarbons which have the branching, which have the side chains with the groups like methyl, ethyl, propyl, butyl, etc. Do three more examples karte hain, then after we will discuss about the nomenclatures of alkene and alkyne as well. See here, now this compound, again we have to find out the first of all longest possible chain. The first rule said that says that the longest possible chain, dekho longest possible chain hamara ye ho sakta hai, this is can be the longest possible chain. I am making it the rectangular box in order to avoid the mistake. Aap bhi aisa kar sakte ho pencil se at the time of examination, but in case agar aap aasani se kar pa rahe ho to there is no need to write as such. Then after LSR rule means lowest sum rule, kiska lowest sum rule, the groups which is present will guess the least position. So I am just going to write the numbering from here, 1, 2, 3 and then 4. ठीक है, तो CH3 that is a methyl group, it is present on the third carbon atom. But I shall start the numbering from this side, that is 1, 2, 3 and then 4. So here I am getting this carbon as a 2 position, and this from this 2 position this methyl group it has exactly which is the less than this is number 3. So the numbering from this side is correct, exactly this is the least sum rule ki jo groups present hai usko least position milna chahiye. So this numbering is incorrect, hame iska preference nahi lena while writing the nomenclature. We will use this 2 word over here. On second position we have used that CH3. For CH3 the nomenclature is methyl, so you will write over here 2 hyphen methyl. Remember there is always a hyphen between the number that is a numeral and the word while writing the IUPAC nomenclature. 2, methyl in the parent chain, the number of carbon atom is 4. For 4 carbon atom, butyl word will be written, and since the single bonding is there, so ane word will be written. So its nomenclature will be 2-methyl-butane. Since just because of 4 carbons, so butyl word is written, single bonding, so ane. This is how you can write the nomenclature of hydrocarbons which have the branching also. Let's see one more example, because there are some more changes here. I will tell you how to see. See, this is a one more important question, and number of times you will find out the questions relevant to this, very equal to this question you will find in some of the sample papers also. Ab yahan dekho kaise karte hain. Sabse pehla ka hamara, don't be confused, compound dekhe confused nahi karna, just only stick to your rules, whatever you know. Rules, jyada rules hum log ke paas hai nahi, only 3 rules we have, that longest possible chain, least sum rule, and then after prefix, word root and suffix. This 3 simple rules, stick to your rules, you are not going to make any mistakes while writing the nomenclatures. First of all, longest possible chain. Remember again, longest possible chain ka matlab chain longest hona chahiye, jaruri nahi ki wo straight ho. So, but in case here easily we can find out ki longest possible chain hamara yahi hai. Means longest possible chain means having the more number of carbon atoms. 1, 2, 3, and 4 carbon atoms. For here also, dekho, we can find out the 4 carbon atoms. 1, 2, 3, and 4. 1, 2, 3, and 4. ठीक है? तो वहाँ से भी हमें मिल सकता था. But while I am teaching you, हो सकता है वो चीज़ आपके लिए difficult हो जाए जब मैं यहाँ से जाके ऊपर की तरफ move कर जाऊँगा या downward आ जाएंगे. तो there will be little bit difficult for you to understand. So that's why I am taking this straight one only. आप इसे भी लेके कर सकते हो. The nomenclature will be the same. After this, you can try it as well. So now, then after you have to apply LSR rule, that is the lowest sum rule. देखो यहाँ पे एक word मैंने बोला अभी, that is a word I told you, that is a sum, S-U-M sum, but I haven't discussed about this. अभी तक मैंने sum word के बारे में discuss नहीं किया. देखो ये discuss कर रहे हैं अभी, what is this sum word. So then after, first of all, first write the numbering over here, give the numbering, 1, 2, 3, and then 4. So here you can find out that is the methyl group is present on the second carbon. So 2 methyl group is present, CH3. So 2 methyl group is present on the second carbon atom. So that's a sum rule. Dekho, given that sum rule, on second position we are obtaining 2 methyl groups. So for the sum rule, lowest sum rule, you write over here 2 plus 2, which is equals to 4. What happens if we start numbering from left hand side here, like 1, 2, 3, and then 4. Here I can find out the methyl group is present on the third carbon atom. Since 2 methyl group is present over here, so we will write over here 3 plus 3, because the rule itself says that the least sum rule, SUM sum, which means the addition. 3 plus 3, so here you are getting 3 plus 3 is equals to 6. Ab aap khud hi dekh lo yahan pe, which one is the least number, whether it's a 4 or the 6. So of course I'm sure that you are going to say the 4 one. So therefore we will, while writing the nomenclature, we will take the reference of the numbering that is written on the upper side. So, theek hai, to isko remove karte hain, let's start the numbering. Sorry, let's start the writing the nomenclature. On second, we have the methyl groups. 2 methyl group is written on the same carbon. So you'll write over here 2, 2. Remember, there will be the comma between the two numerals. So numbers ke beech mein yahan pe comma karenge. 2, 2, -. 2 methyl groups is written, so the word that is a di word will be written, 2, 2, di, methyl word is written. So why methyl word will be written? Because the CH3, and CH3 we use the word methyl. 2, 2, dimethyl, in the parent chain the number of carbon atom is present. The number of carbon atom present is the 4 carbon atoms, that is the word root 4 carbon atoms, but word will be written. 2, 2-dimethyl, but, and then single bonding. So single bonding, the suffix will be used over here is the ane word, already I told you. So this is how you can write the nomenclature of hydrocarbons which have branching as well, using the utilizing the rules, that is the longest possible chain, least sum rule, along with the prefix, word root and suffix, we have found like 2,2-dimethyl-butane. Now let's see how can we write the nomenclature of alkene and alkyne as well. See, how can we write the nomenclatures of alkenes? Here I am erasing the board. Yeah, I erase it. See, in case if I am writing C2H2, sorry, CH2 double bond CH2. We know that in alkynes presence of double bond nahi. No any of the prefixes we have to use because you can very easily can find out ki koi chlorine, chlorine, bromine kuch bhi aisa nahi present hai yahan pe. Even none of the CH3, C2H5, C3H7 or C4H9 group is present. So prefix ki yahan pe koi dikkat nahi. Directly we'll switch to the word root. For word root, the number of carbon atom is present is the 2. So the word root that we are going to use here is the eth word. Since the double bonding is present, the suffix will be used here ene. So its nomenclature will be ethene. Okay, similarly if I am writing here CH3 CH double bond CH2. देखो अब यहाँ पे थोड़ा सा ध्यान देना है while you are writing the nomenclature of this type of hydrocarbons. So देखो कैसे भी आप करेंगे, सबसे पहला काम हमारा the longest possible chain find out the longest possible chain. I won't think that there won't be any problem to find out the longest possible chain क्योंकि कोई branching नहीं है यहाँ पे, it's the chain only itself given, it's the longest possible chain. Then after LSR rule, remember it's clear that there is no any functional group is present but still double bonding is present, means the ene alkene is present which will act even as a functional group. So usko hume least position dena hai. So how we are going to give it the least position? If I'll start the numbering from this side, like 1, 2, and 3. So double bonding is getting started from the second carbon atom. What happens if I'll write the numbering from this side, like 1, 2, and 3. So here the double bonding has started from this very first carbon atom, and according to least sum rule, jo groups present hai, that must be present on the least position, which must get the least position. So ye jo nomenclature numbering humne niche likha hai, that's the incorrect. Hume isi ka use karna hai. Dekho kaise likhenge ab. Since the number of carbon atoms is 3, to proper word will be written. I'm sure that you won't be having any confusion regarding the prefixes over here, ki koi prefix yahan pe nahi use karna hai hame. Ab ye mat kehna ki CH3 present hai to sir why we are not writing as a methyl, since I told you jab ye tak ye sabhi groups aapke, when these groups are present in the branching, like here in case, like in the branching they are present, then only you are going to use as a prefix. So the 3 carbon atoms, the prop word will be written. So we will write over here prop word. Since double bonding is present, the suffix will be written ene word. ठीक है, इससे confused मत होना कि sir the single bonding is also present. Since just because a double bonding is present, just because of presence of this double bonding, entire property of this hydrocarbon will be changed and it will be resembled to alkene. So that's why ignoring this single bonding, we will write here as a ene. So, this ene is present on the first carbon, so we'll write here prop 1 ene. But we know that in mathematics, like we write as a 2/1 can also be written as a 2. Similarly here also this one word can be omitted and we can write here as a nomenclature, that is a bropene. This is how you can write the nomenclature of alkenes. Let's see one more nomenclature and then after we will end this alkene also, like CH3 CH double bonding CH CH2 and then after CH3. Here you are going, how you are going to write the nomenclature. So first of all, the longest possible chain, this is your longest possible chain, and since it's the longest possible chain, how we are going to write the nomenclature, sorry, then after least sum rule. For least sum rule nahi samajh mein aata hai, kuch nahi karna hai, just start giving the numbering through the carbon atoms from both the direction, from this there's a left to right or from right to left. Theek hai, dekho wahi kaam karte hai yahan pe. 1, 2, 3, 4 and then 5. So here the double bonding is getting on the second carbon atom, but if I'll start the numbering from this side, dekho abhi yahan se karte hain, then what will happen? 1, 2, 3, 4 and then 5. Here the carbon atom is getting on the third carbon atom. Sorry, double bonding is getting on the third carbon atom. Exactly, it's wrong. ठीक है, क्योंकि हमें in least sum rule we know that कि least position मिलना चाहिए. Here I am getting the least position. So we are going to utilize this one only number. In the parent chain, the number of carbon atoms is 5. For 5 carbon atoms, the word we have to use here is the pent word. And then after ene is present, ene is present on what position? Second carbon atom. So we'll write here pent 2 ene. देखो अब यहाँ पे like in the previous case one word was omitted, that's the the number one word omitted, but here in this case ऐसा हम नहीं कर सकते, we have to write only pent 2 ene. Pent 2 ene हमें यहाँ पे लिखना ही पड़ेगा. ठीक, एंड वन मोर इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग इज देट, देखो दिस पेंट टू इन कैन ऑल्सो भी रिटन एज ए पेंटिंग टू, और इट्स कैन भी रिटन टू, यहाँ पे भी लिख सकते हो. देर आर द डिफरेंट वेज ऑफ राइटिंग द नॉमिक्लेचर, ये भी करेक्ट है, वो दोनों भी सही है, बट मोर फ्रिक्वेंटली आई टीच विद दिस वन. ठीक है, जस्ट बिकॉज इससे क्लियरली हमको पता चलता है दट इज ए इन इज प्रेजेंट ऑन द सेकंड कार्बन एटम. दिस इज हाउ यू कैन राइट द नॉमिनक्लेचर ऑफ एल्कीन्स एज वेल. और एल्काइन के भी कुछ इसी तरीके से डिस्कस करते हैं, देन आफ्टर इट्स विल बी ओवर. लाइक CH ट्रिपल बॉन्डिंग CH, बिकॉज वी नो दैट कि कार्बन हैव द वैलेंसी फोर बॉन्डिंग कंप्लीट है, थ्री बॉन्डिंग यहाँ पे, एक हाइड्रोजन साथ फोर कंप्लीट. सिंस टू कार्बन एटम्स आर देयर सो एथ वर्ड विल बी रिटेन ओवर हियर. एंड फॉर ट्रिपल बॉन्डिंग द सफिक्स आइन वर्ड विल बी रिटेन. सो विल राइट हियर एथाइन. क्यों नहीं यूज कर रहे हैं यहाँ पे लेटर वन एंड टू, बिकॉज इट्स अ वन और टू, तो वन को यूज करो आप चाहे नहीं करो, दैट्स आई लिटरली इज राइट नाउ आई टोल्ड यू, इट्स अप टू यू. सिमिलरली इफ द कंपाउंड इज गिवन CH3 C ट्रिपल बॉन्ड CH, सो थ्री कार्बन एटम्स आर गिवन. सिंस थ्री कार्बन एटम्स आर गिवन हियर, प्रॉपर वर्ड विल बी रिटेन, नो प्रेफिक्सेस विल बी यूज, नो फ्लोरिन क्लोरिन ब्रोमिन इज गिवन हियर, नो मिथाइल इथाइल प्रोपाइल ग्रुप इज गिवन एज अ ब्रांचिंग ओवर हियर. थ्री कार्बन एटम्स आर गिवन, सिंस थ्री कार्बन एटम्स आर गिवन ओवर हियर, तो प्रॉपर वर्ड विल बी रिटेन. एंड देन आफ्टर इफ प्रॉपर वर्ड विल बी गिवन एंड द ट्रिपल बॉन्डिंग स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट कार्बन एटम 1, 2, 3, सो प्रोप वन आइन. सो आई टोल्ड यू इट्स अप टू यू, आप वन लिखो चाहे मत लिखो, इट्स ऑल अप टू यू. सो यू विल राइट ओवर हियर प्रोप आइन. सो दिस विल बी इट्स नॉमेनक्लेचर. दिस इज हाउ यू कैन राइट द नॉमेनक्लेचर ऑफ एल्काइन एज वेल. अब एक एग्जाम्पल और देख लेते हैं. CH3 CH C ट्रिपल बॉन्डिंग CH. Yes, this will be your task. How can you write the nomenclature of this one? This is how we discussed about the nomenclature of simple hydrocarbons like alkene, alkene and alkynes. Still, if you have some doubts regarding this, any of the things, kuch bhi aisa agar doubts hai, do let me know in the comment section. I'll make a proper video solution for that also. I'm not continuing this to the functional group also because video is already too lengthy. In next part, we will discuss about the nomenclature of functional groups, means as a compound, jise, let's say if the OH group is present, CHO is present here, COH is present over here. So in that case, how we are going to write the nomenclature? This video will be very lengthy if I am going to cover that in those functional group also in this part only. So till the time, keep watching me, keep progressing your subject chemistry. Till the time, have a good learning.